And it's here, the Nvidia 3070 GPU, and we have been testing it like crazy. We got our hands on it extremely early. We were first in the queue to be able to get our hands on this amazing card. So as a crypto mining channel here, obviously you want to know the hash rates. That's exactly what we've got for you. We're going to do a full unboxing. We're going to give you a little tour of the card that we used, show you all the features, see what's around the card. So let's get straight into it. So just to let you know, we've also got a 3070 benchmarking results that is out now as well. Although we might be a cryptocurrency mining channel here, we wanted to extend a graphics card shaped olive branch to all the gamers out there watching this, because we know this information is really important to you. So we wanted to do our best to get all this data and get it straight to you as fast as we can. And you never know, maybe after this, we could be the only YouTube channel that's loved by gamers and miners. So please let us know in the comments if you really think that's possible. Before we get into the video, please make sure to like and subscribe to our channel. So if you're a gamer watching this, wondering what the hell am I doing on a crypto channel, go on, I dare you, give us a like. If you're a miner, guess what? Also, give us a like. So here it is. So it's a day of release and we managed to pull some strings to get the brand new Nvidia RTX 3070. So if you didn't know already, we've actually got two of the videos out there already reviewing the 3080 and the 3090, here and here. And now it's a turn of the 3070 to show us what it's really made of. Cue the unboxing. So here it is, the RTX 3070. This is the Asus OC edition with dual fans, which is a pretty premium version of the card. Now this card has some really interesting unique features that we don't expect a lot of other 30 series cards to have. Being a more premium version that Asus have come out with, the results might be slightly higher than an off-the-shelf 3070. Ultimately, time will tell, but we wanted to show you what the best of the book is going to be able to do and ultimately give you a good understanding of what else might be out there. So one of the first things to note is, of course, we have dual 8-pin sockets. So this is, of course, to do with the higher TDP of this generation of cards. It's going to be much more standard that dual 8-pin is a commonality. So compared to the 20 series, that wasn't common at all. It was different SKUs had different clock settings, which subsequently meant different TDPs, which subsequently meant different pin adapters. So here we have two sets of 8. Now, whether any other of the models this year or different manufacturer SKUs will have an 8 and a 6, time will tell. I would suggest most of them like this are going to have two 8 pins, which shouldn't be a problem for anyone running a normal PSU. So again, this being a more premium card, we've got the back plate of the card, which is a more premium feature for thermal distribution. Of course, this kind of helps dissipate the heat across the back plate. So you can see that's a nice metal card there. And the card generally feels really high quality with much more metal than you might get on some of the cheaper SKUs. Another thing, of course, which is really unique and kind of the unique feature to this card is we've reverted back to the 2000s and we have a manual overclock switch physically on the card. So as you can see here, there's a tiny little switch on the top, which ultimately means you can switch from basic settings to overclock settings. Of course, you're going to be able to see firsthand how this affects the results. And ultimately, that's going to make this card a little bit more interesting, but should give you a pretty good understanding of some of the more interesting things some manufacturers are putting on this new generation of cards. Now is the time to kind of explain from one miner to another what the implications of this new card might be. The physical features are quite interesting. So of course, having extra juice to be able to overclock is pretty good in the fact that we might be able to get some extra horses out the hash power. Now, of course, it all comes down to efficiency, as the tests are going to illustrate, but being able to have that extra headroom for overclocking is a really interesting thing should we need it. Typically, having a more premium backplate is often advantageous to help with heat dissipation, keep things nice and cool. and it gives the card a bit more of a solid feel. So when you're building your mining rigs, you're able to stick all this together and not worry too much about things kind of shaking around. It gives a bit more stability to the card as well, having a backplate as well as a cooler on the front. It's got a typical dual fan cooler mechanism. So again, this is nothing revolutionary. It's a pretty standard model that's been used for a long time. So it's a fairly thick heat sink, as you can see. So ultimately, the cooling mechanisms of this are going to be pretty damn good. Now, it's not too much of a wide card. It's probably a 2.5 slot card rather than some of the big, massive triple slot cards that we've seen. So ultimately, when you've got lots of these lined up in a rig, it's going to sit quite nicely and isn't going to be anything too obnoxious to be able to build if that is what your plan is to do.
Cool.
So now the most important feature that a lot of you need to be made aware of as miners is this. So you're going to be very familiar with this as a PCIe 3 riser. Ultimately, the 30 series cards and subsequently the big Navi cards as well that are coming out are all PCIe 4, which means this riser will work, but you will be severely limited with the amount of hashes you will receive. So ultimately, unless you're going to plug this straight into a PCIe 4 motherboard, or you're going to use PCIe 4 risers, which at the moment are exceptionally expensive, maybe £50 or £60 each. There's definitely some limitations physically of the current equipment which most miners are using. So for you to go out and kind of plug these straight into your boards is simply not going to happen without losing an awful lot of overhead power. So we need some more of these to be made for PCIe 4. That technology just does not exist yet. So ultimately, this is probably the biggest reservation that people need to be aware of when looking at this for crypto mining. It's going to mean an entire base change of hardware, or simply at least wait for the risers to be updated so we can maybe do some things there as well. So it's not quite as easy to change your existing cards with this if you ever wanted. It's most likely going to be a case of forming an entirely new setup with a different generation of motherboard to support that. So let's get straight into exactly what you're here for, the actual mining results themselves. So we've run through some of the main algorithms that you're going to be very familiar with to give you a pretty good overview of this card. We've also done some tweaks on the overclocks of this card to try and get some benchmarks for ultimate efficiency of hash rate to kind of give hash per watt, which ultimately many of you are interested in. So without further ado, let's jump straight into the numbers. So here you have it, guys. These are the results which we've worked so hard to kind of correlate. So as you can appreciate, it's release day. We've done a crap load of testing. As you can see here, we've ran through not just what it's hashing, but the optimum overclocks as well. So as you can see here, the green is simply the out of the box numbers. So zero core, zero memory, 100% power. So straight out of the box, the card is doing around 220 watts and you're looking at 51.6 hash. So really interesting kind of scores straight out the doors there. And as you can appreciate, we've played with many different variations. These are all using Gminer 2.29. And ultimately, with lots of playing and testing, we've got it down to the optimum here, which is in the purple, which is at 90 core, 1500 memory. These cards are amazing for memory overclock, and just 50% power. And that's gotten us all the way to down to 130 watts per card, which is tiny, for 62.9 megahash, which are some really, really impressive numbers. So that gives us an efficiency of 0.48 watts per hash, which is certainly a very impressive figure. So let's jump straight back into the next mining algorithm and have a good look at Ravencoin. This algorithm works a bit differently. It stretches the whole width of the card rather than Ethereum, which is just more memory focused. So let's jump straight in and see what we see. So as you can see here, again, we've got a nice green line at the top here for the baseline out of the box numbers. So here you're looking at zero core, zero memory, 100% power. Again here, looking at about 260 watts of power. So slightly different to previous, and that's getting us 25 watts, Josh, keep with it. So 25 watts there on Ravencoin, which is a pretty decent number straight out the gates. But again, it all comes down to efficiency of overclock. So by moving a couple of things around, actually it turns out here, the purple overclocks at zero core, 150 memory, and again, all the way down to 50 power, which is really a very heavy power reduction, which is more than we've seen on many, many other cards. That gets us, we lose a little bit of hash down to 23, but it increases efficiency quite substantially with only using 130 watts of power. So pretty much half the power, again, 50% reduction. And that gets us to 0.17 hat per watt, watt per hash. So again, very, very impressive numbers compared to other cards which are currently out there. So that was Ravencoin there. Ultimately, it's a much wider algorithm. It stretches both sides of the cards, both memory and core. So ultimately, sometimes Ravencoin can be one of the best indicators of how good a card is across wider performance, obviously because Ethereum is more single focused on memory speed and memory timing. So ultimately, it was interesting to see just how those results played through. And again, we can underclock this card massively on power, which was something we weren't really expecting to see. So let's flip into the final coin of this video and let's have a look at the Zcoin mining results and see exactly where the numbers lie for that popular coin to mine as well. So as you can see here, the same rule applies, nice and green for baseline out of the box numbers. Again, we're straight back at the top, 260 watts out of the box with 4.648 hash as an average on the out of the box numbers. Again, with some more playing, what we're seeing here is actually quite unusual, where actually the core and the memory remaining at 0 and 0 and a reduction of 50% power gives a much better overall rating than even tweaking with some of the core and the memory. So quite an unusual result here, but all the same, we lost a bit of hash down to 3.14, but due to the huge power saving, we got 0.2415 on the hash rate there. So interesting that we've had to kill so much performance in order to get the efficiency, but ultimately that's brought out some really interesting numbers. So that's not too bad at all, with 4.6 being the highest hash and all the way down to 3.15 at 50% if we played with things. So 3.14 as the best overclock there for Zcoin. So as we kind of flip back now and analyze those results, there's some really interesting things which have been seen. Hopefully those results are going to be quite comprehensive. You can stop and pause the video and go and have a look at those in a bit more detail. As we update this video, we'll also be able to release that spreadsheet for you so you can have a little play with those numbers publicly and just kind of see if there's some improvements, which I'm sure there will be as new versions move, and inevitably there might be some figures there that might need to change a little bit. These are just the quick results from the first day and we just wanted to get them to you in the best form we could, as accurate as we could, as quickly as possible. So it's been a mad day here at Easy Crypto HQ. We've ran across the hills and the valleys to get this card for you as quick as we humanly could. The team have done an incredible job here testing, benchmarking, spreadsheeting to try to get you this with just a few hours after the release. So if you could really give us a like, that would be much appreciated, and subscribe to the channel because we've got more amazing content to come as new releases and new tech things and all things in crypto and review moving forward. So if you want to find out some more information about what we do, take a look around the channel, and we cannot wait to see you again in the next video.